Welcome to our new video. Now let us go through the evolution of electronics. In simple words, we can say that electronics is the study of how to control the flow of electrons. In this video, we will be going through the introduction, history, and application of electronics. Do you know the importance of electronics in our life? Can you just think about a day without electronic gadgets? No, we can't even think about it. We can say that the electronics is a part of our life. The word electronics was taken from electrons, which was discovered by Sir J.J. Thomson. So what is electronics? It's a branch of science and engineering which deals with the controlled flow of electrons through vacuum, gases, or semiconductors. So we can say that an electronic device is a device in which the current flows through a vacuum or gas or semiconductor. All the electronic gadgets have many components in it, like resistor, capacitor, diodes, ICs, etc. These components are made up of semiconductor materials, and the working of the component is based on the amount and direction of current flowing through them. All electronic system used in our daily life is a type of system. The working of the systems depend upon the electronic variables like power or voltage or current, and hence it is known as electronic system. The electronic system is operated by electricity, and it processes information taken from the input and converts into the output for the next level of usage. Most of the electronic system is divided into two categories. One is the communication system and the control system. In communication system, processing and distribution of information happens, while in control system, conversion and distribution of energy happens. An electronic system is divided into three parts: inputs, signal processing circuits, and output. Let's move on to the history of electronics and its development. The three main components in the history of electronics are the vacuum tube, the transistor, and the integrated circuits. Birth of electronics began in the year 1897 with the invention of vacuum diode, then followed by vacuum triode. The major limitations of the vacuum tube was the power consumed even if it is not used, and the filaments get burned out. So in 1948, the transistor was invented, which replaced the bulky vacuum tube. Then later, in 1958, the concept of constructing an entire electronic circuit on a single semiconductor chip was invented. This invention of the integrated circuits created an outstanding change in the electronic circuits and also reduced the size, cost, and weight of the electronic devices. Now let us know about the vacuum tubes, transistors, and integrated circuits. A vacuum tube is a device controlling electric current through a vacuum in a sealed container. It's used as amplifier or also even as on-off switches. The diode is the simplest vacuum tube, which is similar to a light bulb with an extra electrode in it. These devices can be used for many applications as the electrodes get increased. Tubes with three electrodes are called as triodes, and that with four electrodes are known as tetrodes. Transistor, it is a three-terminal semiconductor device that regulates current or voltage flow and acts as a switch or gate for signals. Whenever the signal strength has to be increased, amplification is needed. And this is done by the transistor. Integrated circuit. An integrated circuit is a unique component that is built with thousands of transistors, resistor, diodes, and other electronic components on a tiny silicon chip. These are the building blocks of current electronic devices like phones, computers, etc. It can function as amplifier, oscillator, timer, or even as a computer memory. These extremely small electronics can perform calculations and store data using either digital or analog technology. In the following years, the ICs with enlarged capabilities of numerous thousand components on a single chip were introduced, such as small-scale integration, medium-scale integration, large-scale integration, very large-scale integration, and ultra-large-scale integration ICs. From the figure, we can see the number of components used in each ICs. JFETs and MOSFETs, digital integrated circuits, microprocessors, analog integrated circuits were developed in the following years. That's all about the fundamental understanding of the electronic history. Let's move on to the application of electronics. Electronics play a vital role in almost all domains of our life. It has entered in every field from an ordinary timepiece to supercomputers, from bedroom to office, and we can see electronic items everywhere. In medical field, it is not only used to assist in the analysis and determination of medical difficulties, but also in research purpose. All tests rely on electronic devices to do their work quickly and accurately. In industry field, day by day the use of automatic control system is increasing. The operation of automatic door openers, lighting system, power system, safety devices, etc. are controlled by the electronic circuits. The automobile industry is one of the fastest growing area in the world. The most important application is the electronic ignition, which provides improved timing of the ignition spark, particularly at high speeds. Electronic applications are even used in defense and aerospace. The most important application for common people is the consumer electronics, which are devices and equipments meant for everyday use. So we can conclude by saying that electronic is having a great opportunity, and our daily lives cannot happen without electronic appliances. Technology is progressing quickly in the field of semiconductor, and advanced electronic application will shape the world. Thank you for watching the video. For more details, you can visit our website or mail to us. Thank you.